On this day, we baptize you. Being recognized of our Savior who died, but then was resurrected. God be the glory.
Thank you. Yeah. hear me? All right. Amen. Amen. It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm getting over a touch of flu or something. That's why I'm just doing a reading out just like this. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And at this time, thanking God for all of his blessings, both small and great, for his goodness and his mercy that he's extended toward us. I'm going to ask that you all stand so that we can have our responsive reading,
Yes. Which
is coming from page 580 in the hymnal. Those of you that are using your Bibles, go on to the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 28, verses 18 through 20. And also we'll be a reading from the book of Romans, chapter 6, verses 3 through 11. That's St. Matthew, chapter 28. 18 through 20, Romans chapter 6, verses 3 through 11, or page 580 in the hymnal. Everybody got that? Amen. Need a little time to say hold up. Amen. We're ready to go. Amen. I'll begin, you will follow, we will pause at the end of the Matthew so that those of you that buy it. Can adjust. Amen.
Yeah.
And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth.
Go ye therefore into all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost,
teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even up to the end of the world. That's the Gospel of St. Matthew. Take a minute. One of Romans. Beginning at verse 3. Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life.
For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall also in the likeness of his resurrection.
Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin.
For he that is dead is freed from sin.
Now, if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him.
Knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, died no more, death has no more dominion over him.
For in that he died unto sin once, but in that he liveth unto God. Altogether, likewise reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Amen. And at this time, we're going to ask all our visitors to stand if there be any. Any visitors in the house? On behalf of Antioch East Baptist Church and Pastor Michael A. Smith, we welcome you to this house of worship. Sing and shout and let God have his way. And we look forward to seeing you again. Amen. Please be seated. At this time, the Courtesy Guild is going to come in their own way.
Good morning, Antioch East.
Good morning.
following are the announcements of this first Sunday, March 4th, 2018. Please listen attentively and note that the announcements may also be viewed on the monitor to my right or via our weekly email newsletter. Yes. Let's start off with a couple cards here, man. First of all, we have one from the family of brother Anthony Wallace. Yes. Because of you, church, there's someone who is thanking God today, someone who appreciates your warm and caring way, someone who's remembering the special things you do and wishing you his blessings every day, the whole year through. May God continue to bless Antioch East with love and presence. We will never forget you all. God bless from the Allens family. And also, we want to thank everyone who prayed for us, sent cards, made phone calls, and shared with our church. How blessed my brother was to have you all. Yes. You cleaned out his apartment, that's love. His mother, Margaret Towner, and sister, Eartha Mattis.
Yes.
That's from the Anthony Wallace family.
Yes. Yes.
To Pastor Sister Smith and the entire Antioch East family, thank you so much for your prayers and concerns during my illness. So proud to be part of this church family. Love you all. May God continue to pray as God continues to heal me. Sending you many thanks. God bless you, Mother Trina Ross.
Amen.
You have no idea how amazing you are. You go out of your way to care about others, sharing your strength, wisdom, and love in ways that lift spirits and touches hearts. You're amazing in all that you are and in everything that you do. Thank you, the Huff and Patterson family. Attention, parents, grandparents, aunts, and uncles. We will be kicking off our first annual teen meetup for ages 13 to 17.
Yes.
The first meeting will be Sunday, March 18th, that's next Sunday, immediately following morning worship in the Sunday school area. This will be a place for our teenagers to come and discuss the daily issues they face and provide them biblical principles to help them become effective problem solvers.
Yes.
The teen meetup will be every second and third Saturday starting April 7th at 12 noon following the J.E. Howard choir rehearsal. I'm asking for all teens to come out for fun and fellowship. If you have any questions, please see Sister Denise Black for more information. Usher Ministry 1 will be meeting next Sunday, March of, teen meetup was two Sundays now. It's the first Sunday. Usher Ministry 1 will be meeting next Sunday, the second Sunday, March 11th, immediately after church in the Sunday school area. Thank you, Brother Gary Hargrove.
Yes.
Little dancers needed. If you're 8 years old and under and would like to dance with the Youth Praise Dance Ministry for the third Sunday service in March, please contact Sister Karen Gale as soon as possible at 404-213-4692. Rehearsals begin this Saturday, March 3rd at 12 p.m. Wednesday night Bible study and midweek Bible study. Come out for Wednesday night Bible study at 6:30 p.m. taught by Pastor Michael A. Smith, or Thursday midweek Bible study at 11 a.m. taught by our Pastor Emeritus, Reverend J.E. Howard, followed by lunch prepared by Sister Brenda Scott. We do hope to see you either Wednesday or Thursday to learn more about God's Word.
Yes.
Easter program. There will be a short meeting today in classroom number 1, immediately after service, to discuss ideas for the Easter program. If you would like to participate in the Easter program and cannot attend the meeting, there will be a sign-up sheet next to the Christian Youth Forum board, or you can contact Diane Culquitt or Sister Janice Jackson. Get ready for our annual youth explosion
The youth of Antioch will celebrate the annual youth explosion on April 13th through 15th, 2018. The theme is SOAR, S-O-A-R. That's strength, opportunities, aspirations, and relationship with God, to the next level in God. Join us for a weekend of workshops, talent, showcase, fun, and fellowship, culminating with our Youth Day service, where our speaker will be our own little baritone, Master Darion Woods. Thank you for attending. Here's an important announcement. Men's Day 2018. The Men's Day celebration is March 25th. That's fourth Sunday during the 10:30 a.m. worship service. The speaker for the occasion will be Reverend James Wims from Clark Grove Baptist Church in Stevenson, Georgia. The theme will be Men Marching for Christ. The colors will be black and white. Invite your family and friends now to come and support the men of Antioch on Men's Day. Yes. Thank you, Brother James Terrell, Chairman, and Brother Gary Hargrove, Co-Chair. And please note that anyone wanting to participate in the Men's Day male chorus, please contact Brother Levy and Alexander or Deacon Javaris Bird for more information. Youth workers needed. Have a heart for our youth. Enjoy working with kids. Then the youth department is the place for you. We are looking for people to work with the youth of the church in the following areas. Christian Youth Forum, planning activities for our youth. See Mother Wanda Miller. Outreach Ministry, developing community service projects for our youth. See Sister Pamela Bradley or Dr. Von Culver. Life Skills Ministry, equipping our youth with skills needed to succeed in everyday life. See Mother Janie Wright. Creative Christian Education, planning fun, kid-friendly activities to keep our youth learning about God in creative ways. See Sister Karen Gill. Let us remember to report all birthdays, anniversaries, illnesses, and deaths to the administrative office if you would like to share that information via the email newsletter or calling post. All announcements and special announcements for Sunday services are to come from the administrative office by Thursday prior to Sunday service. Thank you, Sister Teresa Wells, administrative assistant. Please continue to keep our sick and shut-in and bereaved members in your daily prayers, and please visit when you can. Today, our thought for the week is embodied in this little prayer attributed to a rambunctious little boy. Lord, he prayed, please take care of me as I run around this house. Place your arm around my shoulders and your hand over my mouth. Some of us should be praying the same prayer every day. May the Lord bless each and every one of us as we go throughout the week. Say happy birthday to all members born in the month of March. Would you please stand? All members born in the month of March.
Prepared to lift our hearts and our spirits up
in prayer at the altar before the Lord. Thank you. Pretty all the time. Amen. Amen. You ain't got to be spectacular all the time. All you got to do is make it to the end. If you make it to the end, then you will receive the salvation of your soul. Am I right about it? Amen. Amen. I don't want to try to make this. I'm not the preacher today. I ain't trying to be. I told you I'm getting over the flu. Amen. But I just feel this thing in my heart. And, you know, you ain't got to be saved like your neighbor saved. Hey man, you know, when I was coming up in some churches, they used, well, you got to do it this way, you got to do it that way. I found out I ain't got to be saved like that person saved. I just got to be saved. Covered by the blood, amen? Amen. And all I got to do is get to the end of my journey. Walking in the newness of life, amen? Amen. And I thank God, and I know that we're here. I'm still holding on by the grace of God, amen? Amen. Amen. And at this time, we're getting ready to have the offertory prayer by Reverend Beach. Everybody get prepared to receive the offer, to give your offering, pay your tithes, your obligations. Amen. If you need an envelope, please raise your hand. The usher say, hand your envelope. Amen.
I'm sorry. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
What a blessing it is to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
And I say good morning again in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I listen to our choirs, and I listen to the prayer from Reverend Timothy Smith, Reverend Beach, and many times I heard the word hold. Just hold. And it's good to know that we can hold on to God's unchanging hand. And it's good to know that God knows us better than we know ourselves. It's an exciting day today because God has given us another day to live. Well, we don't know if we will finish out this day, but He's given us this second time to live. But we should be excited too. We have more to go down in the water this morning. As I explained to them, the water don't save you. You're saved when you come and give your life to God. But the water is one of the audience within the Bible. And we know that Jesus was baptized. And we follow His path in reference to baptism. I want to take time and acknowledge our live streamers that are with us. We thank God wherever you are that you took the time to tune in and to be with us here at Antioch East Baptist Church. We thank God for that. I want to acknowledge all our visitors again. You don't have to stand. I know they already asked it, but thank you for coming out today. And to our church body, thank God for you. I would like to take this time, and I know Sister Patricia and I have already sent out calling posts, but I do want to say on behalf of Sister Patricia and I, to the pastor aide, to the church body as a whole, thank you for the overshadowing of love that you gave us last week, but you give us every week. And I just want to say on behalf of our family, we thank you. There's something also that I would like to do today. And I know that she does not like to be recognized. But it's so funny when I spoke with Sister Teresa Wells, and I told her that I was going to acknowledge her last week. But then I said, oh, no, she doesn't like to be in the limelight. And I told her I did that, but it stuck with me. And I said, let me be the pastor. Let me go ahead and do what God desires for me to do. And I want to, before I get to Sister Reese, I want to thank one of them, Wade and Emily Lumpkin, for those beautiful decorations. Yeah. I want to thank you so much. I want to thank everyone that stood in this pulpit last week. Darion, all the way over to each and every individual. I want to say to Brother Rogers, thank you for being an excellent, excellent worship leader last week. To those that were a part of paying tribute, I thank each and every one of you all. You touched my heart. And Patricia. But I want to say something. And we're going to get into our sermon. It won't be long. You know, people, when they get up here, it's amazing how we like to show what we know. Brother Harold, last week. I don't know what it was, but Brother Harold's been all up under me this week. I got here on Tuesday. I could smell the pine saw as soon as I drove in the driveway. He didn't give me a chance to sit in the seat before he started dusting. And I told him that I wanted to talk to him for a minute. Asked him to come in my office. But something happened to my nail and my hammer, so I don't know what Brother Harold did with it, but he said, Pastor, I know you're going to get me today. Now, I won't get him because I enjoyed last week. I just want him to know there's always a time, just be ye so ready. So, Harold, we love you so. We thank God, but Brother Charity Pastor, hey, dear to my heart, they have, as you all have allies, the deacons, as the mothers, as everyone, we truly love you. But I want Sister Teresa Wells to please stand so they know who our church administrative assistant is. Sister Teresa, if you don't mind, stand. And I tell you why I asked Sister Teresa to stand, because she, besides my wife keeps up with me on everything. But Sister Teresa makes sure my appointments are in order. She makes sure that I have this and that as a pastor. She regulates the events with me, making sure we're on target. But she did something also. That program that you saw last week, it was created by her. And she did a beautiful job, and we want to say thank you, Sister Teresa. And thank you for always being there for us. We greatly appreciate you. I think that's all the acknowledgments I have in reference to us, but I do want to remind you some individuals in this church. Remember our YAMs, our Young Adult Ministry? For those that are 18 to 30, you are part of the YAMs. You have Brother DJ Sellers, you have Brother David Clark, and you have Sister Chelsea Sneed that are spearheading that. I ask that you get involved in the church. And those that is visiting, if you're looking for a church that is up and coming with their youth department, their YAMs, and their Christian youth form, please look at Antioch East. I want to thank Sister Karen with the youth department. Her arms are already open with her committee, saying, please become a part of us. Christian youth form, please. The issues lies within the church as well as outside of the world. So come and be a part of our Christian youth form with Mother Wanda Miller. If you want to be a part, please be a part. You heard Sister Denise Black. She said, I want to hear the voices of our young people. We got issues going on. Come on in the church so we can discuss those issues. I'm asking you to take part. Amen. At this time, I'm going to ask for Reverend Smith assistant as I come down to the floor. Like we said, today is a special day, and as the pastor, I want to come down to the floor, and I want to express my excitement. We had four to go down in the water. And I just want to read the certificate of baptism. It would say the same for all four women, and it says certificate of baptism. This certifies that the first person was Trinity, Siobhan, Renee, Austin, was baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, on the fourth day of March in the year of our Lord, 2018, at Antioch East Baptist Church, 1223 Hardy Street, Northeast Atlanta, Georgia, 30307. Senior Pastor, Reverend Michael A. Smith, Church Clerk, Mother Mary A. Caribbeans. And it says in conclusion, and this water symbolizes baptism that now saves you. Also not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of clear conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ. That's 1 Peter 3:21. And this time we're going to ask Sister Trinity, does she mind coming forward? Now I want to receive her certificate, but to receive her armor as well. Amen. Sister Trinity. God bless you, Sister Trinity. Our next individual is Jameson Terry Lloyd. Sister Jameson, come forward. Your certificate reads the same thing. And it's signed by your pastor, Reverend Mike Orton Smith, and the church clerk, Mother Mary A. Corinthians. Our next individual is Ms. Taylor Garan Skelton. Ms. Taylor Garan Skelton is signed by your pastor, senior pastor, Reverend Michael A. Smith, Mother Mary A. Caribbeans, our church clerk. We're so proud of you. We also give you your weapon and your certificate. God bless you, Sister Taylor. Last but not least, we have our sister who said, I'm going to be baptized once more. And we thank her for being a brave soldier she was, Sister Valerie Glenda Lloyd. Michael Smith, your senior pastor. The church clerk is Mother Mary and Corinthians. And here is your certificate, my sister. And here is a sword again for you to carry and always know God has you. Amen. Let's give all of our baptism to you. Something with you about being remembered and also holding on to God's hand. We often in life have to be careful how we treat people because you never know in life what will come your way. You never know when you ever cross that bridge again. My mother always taught me, don't ever burn a bridge because you never know when you ever cross over again. And if you burn it, go to that person so you can be able to build a plank to get back across one more time. I want to share a story with you about the apologetic girlfriend. It was this girlfriend that decided to do the Dear John letter. She sat there writing and saying, Dear John, this is yours truly. I want to apologize to you for all the things that I've said and done to you. I want you to know that in my life, I have learned so many valuable lessons. I ask that you please forgive me for the way I treated you in our relationship. She said, I also want you to know that I was wrong. Everything I said and did, the way I treated you, even running off with your best friend and marrying him, I want you to forgive me. She said, baby, please, forgive me for what I've done. I want you to know I filed for a divorce today. And if you would take me back, I surely would come back into your arms. She said, but pray about it and get back with me. Then she said, P.S., congratulations on winning that lottery yesterday. Be careful of what you do. Because you just don't know where you can miss out on your blessings. This morning, our word is going to come from Genesis, the 40th chapter. Verses 13 through 15, that's Genesis, chapter 40. Verses 13 through 15 and verse 23. So that's four verses. You open up Genesis, the 40th chapter, the 13th through the 15th, and then the 23rd. As you get the word, please stand for me. And the word reads, yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thine head and restore thee unto thy place. And thou shalt deliver Pharaoh's cup into his hand and after the former manner, when thou wast to build his builder. But think on me when it shall be well with thee, and show kindness, I pray thee, unto me, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh. Bring me out of this house. For indeed I was stolen away out of the land of the Hebrews. And here also have I done nothing that they should put me in the dungeon. 23 reads, yet did not the chief of them remember Joseph, but forgot him. You may be seated. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, In a time such as this, we need you to be the center of our joy. We need for you to speak through these vocal cords. We need for you to take this mind and invest it what you have to be invested. But God, we need for your people to receive a word today. We need for your people to understand your way.
Yes.
We need for your people to know that you are the only way.
Amen.
So this morning, God, this morning,
yes,
have thine own way.
Yes.
To God be the glory.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Ushers, as you take your seats, just remember this today. God remembers you during your stronghold moments.
All right.
God remember you.
Yes, he does.
During your stronghold moments.
Yes, yes.
We often speak about holding on to God's unchanging hand.
Oh, yes, sir.
We often speak about if you just hold on a little while longer,
yes,
everything is going to be all right.
All right.
We so often say, hold up the light.
Yes, yes.
Hold up the light. But we have taken this text that God has given us today about Joseph. In the Bible, there are many individuals that overcome obstacles.
Mm-hmm.
We could have talked about Job today, but
amen,
this is not a Job moment.
Amen. Amen.
This is a stronghold moment. And
yes,
stronghold, we understand, too, is when you have the fortress or the strength of protecting one's boundaries.
All right, come on.
But there's another stronghold that exists when you are going through it. It seems like you just can't move out of your situation.
All right, come on, preacher.
There is something about Joseph from the beginning of his life. It was always a stronghold moment.
Jesus.
If you knew the background of Joseph, you knew that his mother's name was Rachel.
Amen.
You knew his father was Jacob.
Yes.
But if you know about his mother, did she not weep for many years to be able to have a child? That was a stronghold in her life. She desired to give life. But she also had to remember she doesn't give life. God gives life.
Yes, it does. Come on, preacher.
For those Bible scholars and Wednesday night and Thursday Bible students, well, you know in Genesis what Rachel was known for. She and her sister Leah played tit for tat. Even though Rachel couldn't give birth, she used her handmaid to be able to go up against her sister.
All right.
So even before Joseph came into the picture, there was already a stronghold that was placed in his life.
Yes, Lord.
We understand that even with the Great Wall of China that was created in 221 B.C.
All right.
The purpose was to keep the Northerners from being able to come over and attack them. But when the Great Wall of China was built from the earth and the stones that were in the area, they were able to build it and it covered 3,000 miles.
Yes, yes.
But the walls were built by those soldiers and convicts were the ones that built the Great Wall of China.
Amen.
We talk about the seven wonders and we will find ourselves talking about the Great Wall of China.
Yes, yes.
But I want to talk to you about the wonders that God would do with you as he did with Joseph. You remember, Joseph was one that it did not fray away from it. In the Bible, it said that he was the favorite son of his father.
All right.
The father caused a stronghold with his children. He chose one over the others. But we know that that began with Abraham and Rebecca. So they continued the cycle that was before them, but how would Joseph know what was ahead of him?
All right.
I ask you, are any of you all in a stronghold moment? You got something that's going on, or you're trying to be delivered from something, or you're waiting for that great opportunity? But you got this wall around you called a stronghold that seems to be in your way.
All right, all right.
Does God really remember us when we go great I am, you know, he was a showboater. You know, everybody didn't get a coat of many colors, but he did. And that coat caused a division amongst the brothers. Joseph was a dreamer. And he came forth and told them about all the things he had seen.
All right.
Even with those heifer cows, and he talked about those that were devoured. He talked about the stars and the moon.
Yes, yes.
But in our lives, we're trying to find our way.
Yes, Father.
Joseph tried to find his way. He was young.
All right.
You know we do foolish things when we're young. But the question is, do we do foolish things when we are baby? Joseph may have had the mind of a child, and he was a child, but some of us are adults.
Yes.
But we still have the minds of children. What you do to me, I'll return back to you.
Well.
What you say about me,
well,
I'll say even more about you.
Well.
When you cross a line, I will cross too. And dare you to cross me.
Yes.
Joseph is in a place and time where strongholds did exist.
All right.
He found himself hated by his brothers, and they went ahead and built up an opportunity to sabotage him. The dreamer.
Yes.
How can you be in a place and time that you feel great about who you are, and the next thing you know, it's upside down, and you have no control over where you are? Has any of you ever looked at a stronghold as a curse? Have you ever looked at it in a particular time and place, and in your mind you say, God, what have I done to deserve this? Well, I want to talk to you about just a couple of things about the stronghold. First of all, you need to know that a stronghold exists before us. In your life, you're going to find that life is life. And with life comes the woes of life. But in life also comes the celebration of great things. When things happen to us that cause us to be somewhat dysfunctional, causes us to be broken, causes us to be shattered.
All right.
We ask God, why me? Why must I go through this? But I ask you, how can you ask God, why me, when God is the one that created me? How can you ask God, why not, when God said it shall be? Oh, we all have had strongholds. A stronghold also is someone that's trying to keep you from your destination. A stronghold will sometimes meet myself and I.
All right.
You will find yourself in a battlefield struggling with yourself. If you don't get out of God's way. You're always asking somebody, when will my change come? The question is, when will you change in order for your change to come? Surrender all.
Yes.
Are you being able to say, God, I don't control this?
Yes.
But you do.
Yes, sir.
See, Joseph was sold into slavery.
All right.
Not that he went ahead and voluntarily sold himself. He was sold out of a choice of his.
Yes.
Joseph was wondering, what did I do to deserve this? But even in the midst of the slavery, God showed favor. When he went to Potiphar's house, he was shown great favor. Potiphar entrusted Joseph with everything he had. It's almost like you. Who do you trust with everything that you have? Who will you give the carte blanche of the power of attorney to if something was to happen to you? You know, we know our children. We know them in a sense. You know that child that you can depend on.
Yes.
And you know that child who says, as quick as I'm gone, I'll the papers will be signed.
Yes, yes.
But you make a decision who will be responsible for you.
Yes,
and sometimes it's not a children that you would depend on. You would go elsewhere. Where to find somebody that you have entrusted. Where Potiphar had entrusted Joseph enough to say, I'm going to leave you in my house.
All right.
And I'm going to trust you with everything that I have. Even down to my wife.
All right.
But there was a stronghold up in that house.
Uh-huh.
It was called the wife of Potiphar, and
Jesus.
She had already set her mind on what she wanted. But we found Joseph being one of integrity, one of character.
Right.
See, when we're even in a moment of stronghold, even in the moment we're going through, you got to keep your integrity.
Yes,
you got to keep your character. You got to keep your mind right. You got to stay in the right place. About, do you realize that we always will have those strongholds before us?
All right, yes, Lord.
There's division amongst our family members.
Oh, yeah. Come on, tell me about
it. You don't want to believe it, sometimes there's division amongst our church members.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But one thing we can agree on is that if we trust God, those strongholds will not be a problem for us. We must also be able to differentiate between God's stronghold and the devil's stronghold. I want to tell you about God's stronghold. God's stronghold will give you the truth and the purpose. And it won't lie to you. But what you will find that devil's stronghold is this. Satan will disguise the truth and the purpose. Believe that it is right.
Yes,
see, God's stronghold was when Joseph was sold. He came in and intervened and allowed Joseph to still have favor. Satan's stronghold was to sell you and then let Potiphar's wife go ahead and try to tempt you and then you get put in prison. That was his stronghold. And you say, was the devil successful? Oh, no, he was not. The devil may have thought he had gained because he was in prison.
Yes.
But one thing about Joseph being in that prison, God had to do some fine pruning and tuning in order for you to be ready for the greatness that he has for you. If you're going to be ready for God's greatness, you want God to clean you up and clean you out. You want God to lift you to a place where you need to be in order to work for him. It is in 2 Corinthians and 10 verses 3 through 4, and it says, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, to the pulling of the stronghold. Our God holds the stone. We don't have to worry about the battle. All that we got to do is shout now because we won the battle. Only through God. You ask yourself too with this mind of Joseph that even when you got hate in your heart and your mind is elsewhere, God will put you in a place if you're willing for him to work on that heart while he's working on everything else in your life. See, Joseph was there in those years that he was down in that dungeon. He was still praying and hoping. See, when he entered into Egypt, we know that he was 17. And we know years had transpired in reference to God working with him. Even when you feel defeated, you got to flip the script and see that you've been rewarded. Even when you feel lost, you got to know you've been found. Even when you be discouraged, you know that around the door is encouragement. It's just when you decide to let your stronghold be. Joseph was finding himself in a place and time like we do today. You know, one of the strongholds in the United States, and we always talk about the Mexican border. Talk about building this wall, but one thing we found out about people, there's always another way in to where you want to go. They always realize when one man closes the door, God's door never closes. He decides. But you got to be willing. You got to have that mind and thought.
Yes, yes.
But I ask you this. One of the other things I ask. How are you positioned during your stronghold moment? Where do you put yourself when you are in that moment? You know, it's often said that a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
That's right.
It says,
yeah.
An idle mind is the devil's workshop. It tells us, so is a man thinking, so is he. About the situation.
Amen. Come on.
You find yourself praising God for the situation.
Yes.
God, whatever this is meant to be, whatever I'm going through, God, no matter how long it takes, God, no matter how dark it gets, God, no matter how heavy it gets, God, no matter where you take me, God, no matter how long you keep me, God, no matter what you do to me, God, I know that there's greatness that's in your hands. Because the word is true.
Yeah.
he loves you, Satan hates you. Satan is on this war ground trying to take you out. Satan wants you to keep your minds off of God and live elsewhere. One thing about God, he goes beyond all waters. One thing about God, he goes above every mountain. One thing about God, he goes into the deepest of woe. He sat there and Joseph said, when is my time coming? I've been many years down here. I've seen those that come and go sometime in your life. You got to see those that come and go before God sends you on your way. Sometimes you got to hurt sometimes. Sometimes you got to cry sometimes.
Yeah.
And that thing is saying, crucify him, crucify him. I told him, what goes for me, goes for him. I also told him, too, that God will do his work in you. But see, what I want to say, we have to be crucified sometimes. We have to be put across the table sometimes. We have to be shaken up and shaken off. We have to let that say, no brother, who do you think that I am? Don't you see the blood of Jesus all over me? Don't you see the crown of glory all around me? Don't you see me when I wave my hand? You can see the lightning flashing. Can you hear the thunder roll? Oh, you can't mess with God's
throne.
But it says too. What is in the ring? 28, almost 29 years ago, somebody put this on my finger. And when they did, never worn jewelry before. My hand swelled for a little while. I know what she put on that ring. And we were talking about getting a change of rings, and I went to the jewelry smith to cut that thing off. I said, well, it must be God's will.
Come on.
It won't go anywhere but around and around.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
But when I trust in God, I remember what this ring is about.
Yeah,
Joseph was given a ring.
Yeah,
a ring was placed on his finger.
Okay,
no matter what you try to do to block another man's blessing, or a woman's blessing, when God put the ring on your finger, you can't do nothing about it but just say, thank you, Jesus. Know this. Know your stronghold moment. Can be your glory moment. Know your stronghold moment can be your glory moment. See what God would do while you up there complaining everything. God would just sit right there and have dust on you. But when you decide to surrender to Him, He'll start doing this and then cleaning you up. And the next thing you know, you'll start shining.
Yeah, yeah,
I remember when I was in ROTC, we had brass and we had to polish it every week.
Yeah.
And then going around looking at it every week. And I remember somebody looked at my brass and couldn't have a fingerprint on it. And I used to look at him and I said, he's just trying to start trouble.
All
right. And I said, if I ever become in his position, I'm going to treat him right.
All right, come on.
God put me in that same position where I was battalion commander, going around checking everybody's prayers. And what God reminded me, much is given, much is required. Be careful what you're asking for. Because when you get it, make sure you know how to use it. When you get it, make sure you know how to praise it. When you get it, make sure you know how to surrender. When you get it, know that it's God. Know that it's God. You're removing contamination with man. Sometimes you got to get away from man and get with God all by yourself. Because if you're with man, they can contaminate your thoughts. They can contaminate your deeds. They can contaminate your heart. But you get with God, He will start speaking. You get with God, He will start talking. You get with God, He'll start moving. You get with God. You find yourself doing something you never thought of doing. Open our doors at the church.
Right.
I want you to remember something.
All right.
There's only one stronghold carrier.
Come on, tell it.
There's only one stronghold breaker.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The devil.